Greetings, ascending legion of the 144 of the new earth, rising into the glory of a new day, a new life, a new way. So many higher dimensional activations, frequency, resonance coming in now. The Divine Mother, the Sacred Rose, Magdalene, Gaia rising up, ascending, the Saint Germain codes of the Violet Flame coming in. We will have a lot of the Rose and the feminine energies coming in through the transmissions today, as we do every day with the Goddess Rising, the feminine, the Magdalene, the Shakti energies coming in, the water rise to meet the fire, to bring all into balance, to bring all into harmony, peace, joy. Today I released day one of 33 days of discourses from Saint Germain of the Violet Ray on Patreon. You can receive these on patreon.com/prime disclosure for our team there. The pledges start at $5 a month. And this is just one of the many things that we bring to all of you that support us in our great mission and lineage of the eagle and the condor. So repeat after me, beloved beings of light. I am the way. I am the truth. I am the life. I am the light. I am in perfect balance. I am in perfect harmony. I am the pure presence of divine creator source emanating through this sacred vessel here now in this body that I always am. The I am is God in action, infinitely expanding creator source. Anything that you place after the I am consciousness is a code, is a frequency, is a command, a divine decree. So be careful what we wish for, and be aware of when we say things that bring us down, bring down our energy, such as I am sick, I am tired, I am weak. All these things, those are curses. Those prevent you from living in harmony, abundance, peace, and joy. So we say, I am that I am. I am the peace. I am the way. I am the way in. I am the way everywhere. This is a powerful mantra, a powerful code for all of you. And I that is here now in this vessel transmit to you another I am, a mirror of the one in the many and the many in the one. This code to rise up, to wake up, to lift the spirits. So arise, beloved being of light, into the I am presence. And call upon the powers of the Ascended Masters and Saint Germain of the Violet Flame, the Violet Ray, the Violet Light, if you need assistance in this great mission. But the I Am Presence alone is all the power that you will ever need to fulfill your mission, your purpose, any vision, any goal that you hold in your dear heart. And with the power of silence and stillness, we emanate this pure radiance into the field, into this vessel, into this realm, to uplift and to manifest heaven on earth through our pure consciousness of the I Am Presence. So thank you for joining us on this great mission. Many powerful codes coming in the last 24 hours. We had on the Schumann resonance a power of 35 of the 8 code, many codes coming in, many frequencies, many emanations of light. Today from Divine Sister of the Light, S.A. Smith, energies start to subside a bit, bringing in anything is possible type energies. What a wild ride it's been. We have been inundated lately with massive energies. The big question I am getting now is, when are these going to end? This question has two parts to it. Big energies are supposed to gradually mellow after February 18th. Then increase again from February 27th through March 26th. As with anything in ascension, this answer is also unique to you. The energies coming in are working with your system. If you are doing your inner work and are really making an effort on this journey, the heavy effects of the energies will begin to lessen and change to a much more blissful and euphoric feeling. Yes, you may still have days where you feel off, out of balance, even if you have feeling like you may have been run over by a train, but it won't be a continual thing. You are feeling these so intensely because they are intense. We are doing something that's never been done, and it's incredible. You are incredible. So relax, realize it's all happening exactly as it is needed, uniquely for you. As a creator being, you control all of this. If these energies are too much right now, talk with your guides and ask them to lessen them or set an intention to lower their intensity. You have the power, literally, agirlintheuniverse.com. And again, this is where the I am presence, the I am consciousness comes in. When we say I am empowered, I am full of life, I am full of light, I am unstoppable. This is not egotistical or self-centered. This is activating your true divinity and the true power that resonates within so that we can shift this whole realm, this whole game to that of benevolence and love, truth, and life for all humanity and all sentient beings of pure consciousness. Over the last 24 hours, again, the code 144, 144 earthquakes in the past 24 hours, and 1.5 or greater, the most powerful 5.5 Papua New Guinea, many activations all over this realm, starting in the south of Panama this morning with a 4.7, Peru, in the sacred portal of the Andes Mountains, where our beloved condors fly high, 5.1, 103 kilometers depth, Atlantean energies, British Virgin Islands, 3.7, and then a 3.6 with the Divine Masculine Codes, the Council of Nine coming in, Russia, Shikotan, 4.5, 9 activation, New Mexico, Tierra Amarilla, 3.1, at 3.5, again in the British Virgin Islands, Argentina, South America, and the very southern tip, the most southern point of the Andes, the Kundalini of Pachamama, 4.1, 35 kilometers depth. There's the 35 again that was on the Schumann resonance, and that is 54.808 latitude, 66.871 longitude, 2310 UTC. We have the 8-8 of the Lion's Gate and the 66 encoded within this activation. Philippines 5.0, Idaho 3.3, South of Africa 4.9, 13 of the Divine Goddess. Then we have the 3.3, the 33, to the 6, U.S. Virgin Islands, Solomon Islands 4.9, Peru 5.0, India 4.2, 4.8 Philippines. Then we had the 5.5, most powerful activation on the Ring of Fire again today, Papua New Guinea, Japan 5.0, Costa Rica, Central America 4.5 with the Council of Nine, Japan 4.8, 12 Divine Goddess, British Virgin Islands again 3.6, 2 3.6s, 99 of the Tengri, the Sky Beings, Odell, Oregon 3.5, 3.7, British Virgin Islands, 37 into the 73, Heaven on Earth, Izu Islands, Japan, 5.2, Banda Sea, 5.2, the 77, the Sacred 77, 166 kilometers depth, then Anchor Point in the Crown of Lemuria, United States in Alaska, 3.3, another 33, and then 103 kilometers of the 13, then Texas, Mentone, 4.0, Argentina, 4.4, Puerto Rico, 3.6, Chile, South America, another activation in the Andes with a 4.8, 12 of the Divine Feminine Goddess energies coming in on the Ring of Fire, Lemurian, 5, then in Guatemala, Central America, the Mayan lineage, 4.1, and then in the Sacred Portal of Turkey, 4.8, another 12, 12, 12, the third portal to my sacred condor, and then another crown activation in Healy, Alaska, 3.6, Divine Feminine rising up, arising into the glory of the Golden Age, the Age of Aquarius starts, the new Eden, the new Jerusalem. Again, we start today with the Sabian symbols. Right now, the moon is at 0 degrees, 27 minutes Aquarius, the sun at 21 degrees, 34 minutes Aquarius. The current Sabian symbol for the sun at 22 degrees Aquarius, A rug placed on a floor for children to play on. The current Sabian symbol for the moon at 1 degree Aquarius. An old Adobe mission. From astrologyweekly.com. Today from Divine Sistar of the Light, Sophia Grace. The Way of the Rose. Christ consciousness reborn via the divine feminine. Christ consciousness comes through the activation, awakening, and anointing of the divine feminine within to then awaken and anoint the divine masculine within. For both women and men, and this is also seen without in the collective, with the recent flooding of our planet of the divine feminine ray as the second coming of Christed. We are the second coming. We are able to achieve the consciousness of Christ's light through activating our inner divinity and unity. In these same ways, Mary Magdalene anointed Yeshua so that he became Christed, as he in turn had anointed her to raise her kundalini through the seven gateways, in the ways that ancient priestesses before her had taken light awakening to enable the inner divine masculine to resurrect. This is an energetic and symbolic dance within us all, regardless of gender, religion, or tribe. Christ consciousness is a state of being one with the light body that comes after light awakening or enlightenment that many masters have achieved. Although Yeshua is the main master that we speak about as one who has actually resurrected rather than simply having awakened or ascended upon death, but supposedly did in his lifetime consciously and did not die afterwards but continued in life after the crucifixion, as you can read in many scriptures and books on this subject elsewhere. We may hear of gurus and masters in India such as Babaji or lesser-known sages and prophets, as well as ascended masters, both male and female, from all tribes and all lineages, all over the world, who achieved the rainbow cloak and became one with their light body and ascended into Christed consciousness. Ascension is really an upshift which can encompass anything from a simple awakening to complete mastery and illumination as one merges fully with one's light body, and there can be many different types of awakening in a lifetime. Christed consciousness refers to this most powerful state of light illumination awakening. It is a deep spiritual awakening that brings about a merging with the light body and higher self, which can last forever or be a simple taste until the next time. There are layers of upshifting from one form to another, and then this can lead to Christed consciousness as a resurrection and becoming absolutely one with the light body and higher self, either at the time of death or during life. We can taste it many times in one life, and those of us who have ascended before can more readily attain it. Yet to merge completely is complete mastery, and only a few have achieved this, for it can take lifetimes of practice. We are living in unprecedented times when ascension is prophesied as our future as we return now to the light, and the planet is indeed ascending, and we are all upshifting along with her. Over the next 100 years or so, we will be accessing our light bodies, and those of you drawn here will most likely be working with these feminine energies. From thewayoftherose.com and from Divine Sister of the Light, Chanel Melian Amawi. The Rose Ray, love everyone, even those who test you. One of the greatest practices I have cultivated lately is to send love and compassion to the people that have hurt me, disappointed me, tested me, judged me, suppressed me, or represent any kind of tension that is undesirable in my day-to-day experience. This practice has really revolutionized my life, for real. Some weeks ago, my angels whispered to me on my way back to Sleepland, the Rose Ray, and I started to send the people who represent hurt somehow, love, forgiveness, and compassion from my heart, from my chest, beaming out like a beautiful pink ray. So what I do is that when any thoughts or feelings come up linked to someone that I have some quarrel or bad experience with from the past, I just send that person love and kindness, and the pain dissolves. This practice is also highly inspired by Loving Kindness for Self, 10-day guided meditation practices with Sharon Salzberg. This practice has been so liberating for me, creating space where before there was tension, releasing all energies that are undesirable, or taking up space that I otherwise can fill with love and kindness. In the face of unkindness, stay kind. In the face of hurtfulness, stay heartful. Don't let the lower actions of others take anything away from you. Engulf yourself in the rose pink light and let it nourish you from the inside out. Today, from Divine Sistar of the Light, Carolyn, Servant of Yahweh, March 2021, we enter Aries season and the powerful equinox. Venus joins Aries the very next day for most of Aries season to April 15th, when she moves into Taurus. Eris, Mars, and Aphrodite Venus have played a pivotal role in the cosmos the past few years to clear the distorted masculine-feminine cabal templates for the union of the beloveds. Venus is playing a bigger 8-year cycle role, 2016 to 2023, of removing all Wicca, the pentagram, and spellwork, including the Whore of Babylon, Lilith, Inanna, Ishtar, Isis, Anunnaki, etc., through the Rose of Venus geometric cycle. This will complete the fall of the dark feminine distorted mother template from our universe and the multiverse. This month of February 2021, the Sisterhood of the Rose is succeeding in neutralizing the past dark feminine for good from the Holy Grail. Unity of the divine masculine and feminine Christ continues within and without. We are thriving and will continue to thrive with no interference. Together, we all have been purifying past cycles, karma, and energies for the regenesis, the union of the beloveds, the 144,000 free of Jezebel. Today is a successful new beginning and physical movement forward. Your sovereign power as an embodiment of the light of Creator is giving you new drive and ambition to run down this new pathway. This is a powerful action energy that has begun today, carrying you forward into Aries season. Mother, Father, God have all the Heros Gamos kingdom marriages chosen. The divine masculine Christ are completing a final clearing, healing, and closure of past poor decisions, choices, and behaviors that were destructive to the divine feminine Christ. This is all neutralizing now with forgiveness. This is more expansion of the rising of honest, loyal, and trustworthy divine masculine Christ bridegrooms. God has commanded it. Anything blocking that is being destroyed, one and done. From Carolyn Kundalini Twin Flames. Today, from Divine Sister of the Light, Karen Lithica. The Sun, your personal activation tool, a magnificent being of light allied to Mother Gaia, providing a key role in the ascension process. Know the Sun plays a pivotal role in your upgrade, calibrating light and cosmic codes, and restoring the blueprint of your reality. Integral to the biochemical upgrade of your physical form, coupled with your crystalline form, and a third-dimensional, multidimensional, transitional alignment and adjustment. Know your unique crystalline signature is an important puzzle piece with a unique light mission. To live your mission with your soul team and soul family, assist in the overarching mission of Gaia's ascension. Be of service to humanity to reach unity consciousness. Know the light ray is multidimensional, with multiple trajectories connected simultaneously to multiple timelines. See your 3D vision expanding to a multidimensional framework of light. Send love to the sun and bask in the unconditional rays of love with a mission of unity. Resonate into these words and feel the rays penetrating your field. We ask you to sit and acknowledge the gift of the sun for every being. Much love and gratitude to you as you awaken day by day to the unfolding of your reality. Thank you, warriors of light, for your contribution. Know you are greatly loved by your cosmic family. With love, the Arcturians and Karen Lithica. From KarenLithica.com. From Divine Sister of the Light, Judith Kusel. The loving gift. We are moving into a movement of energies now which is unprecedented. On planetary levels, this is the accelerated movement of the new Earth into expanded form and being, and she is beautiful. She is vibrant, creative, loving, and truly awesome beyond words. As we truly leave the old Earth, the old polarities, dualities, all which divided and separated ourselves from ourselves and others, now is brought into wholeness and unity within. With unconditional love, we step into the truth of our souls as masters. Note that all that is happening in the yet invisible planes, for it is exceedingly high frequency and it is something the soul can tap into and experience and indeed start living. The moment the old is completely left behind and the physical body transforms into a much lighter body, then we will live in full embodiment of a much higher vibrational frequency level. It may seem at times as this is all happening and transforming and transfiguring that we are challenged, and most of all, that all is being churned up which we have not forgiven or dissolved nor made peace with inside of ourselves. More than this, it will often bring about that we will want to cling to the familiar, the chartered, yet all of these are but fears conjured up by the mind. It is wise to move more and more into the heart center and reconnect with the highest truth of your own soul, to seek stillness within and guidance within, and to connect in the deepest levels with the divine within yourself. The more you make time for this, the more empowered and enabled you will be to cope with these changes and step fully into the highest truth of who and what you in truth are. Ask for guidance and wisdom. Ask that you walk in the company of heavens and that you will be shown the way. Open the heart center to every higher levels of divine love and unconditional love for yourself and others. Connect in the deepest sense with your own soul, for all the navigational tools are there within your own soul. I make time each morning, getting up before sunrise, to truly become as one with the divine and embrace the divinity within myself. These are the most precious, inspiring moments, and indeed this is what fuels and lifts me throughout the day. It is here that the most profound guidance comes, and with it immense gratitude, awe, and wonder. If we do not make time to go deep within and seek the ultimate oneness with the divine source, we will not be able to navigate these immense changes on all fronts now. For remember, not only is your own physical body going through immense changes, but so are all your energetic bodies, and with it, your inner self is embracing its divinity as one with the divine source, and thus is being lifted into the highest truth of the soul. Your vibration frequencies are changing, and you're going to change to the core within and without, thus in making time for quietude, stillness, and prayer, or whatever you wish to call it, assist you in ways that I cannot even put into words. Indeed, we are stepping into the most amazing new earth and new way of life and living, which so often when I am shown this moves me to tears of wonder and awe. At first, we need to allow ourselves to be transfigured and step into the fullness, the truth of who and what we are, before we can access all of this. What an immensely beautiful, powerful, and loving gift. From JudithKusel.com. And from the Archangelic Calendar. Gaia is in Circe's will, Circe our galaxy, acts upon the infinite universe's will. The current setting element is water. This setting means that we are working with the divine flow and are steadily traveling towards new shores. We see the macro of reality shift as consciousness is ever growing. We are flowing like the mighty Amazon. We see the opening of a 144 gate in the hexadecimal perspective. There is an excellent balance in the binary persuasion as well. The macro is encouraging us to have great expectations as to what is to come. The Vedic Legion from Inner Earth has joined the legions. They have many appropriate units to fit into, but seem to gravitate to the bravest legion, the Mythical Legion, and the Hybrid Angel Legion. Establishing a global community is more important now than ever. The wonderful community that facilitates the Archangelic Calendar will be doing more projects designed to foster macro service. Community means that we walk each other home as we find support in our soul family. We must remember the rallied group around the calendar is not new and has many different names from days of old. Even though the characters and methodology have changed, the cooperative spirit of physical and non-physical is ever present. There is a good deal of quantum evidence to suggest that we took a drastically different direction via a bold timeline jump somewhere around 8 to 9 orbital turns ago. This statement means that we are nowhere near the original timelines we were born. The prophecies come to full fruition when we realize that Earth's great teachers have also evolved into something completely different in this now. Legion and 5D hodgepodge. There is more than a rumbling about a great gathering in the planning stages. The guests will come from many places near and far, but the theme is a family reunion. Archangel Michael opened many huge macro valves that will bring in an influx of transformation of the highest persuasion. It is nothing short of incredible to see Mikael work in his upgraded position, but this was a collaborative effort with Archangel Metatron, who made room for these events to happen. This event will account for the happy summery feeling that we will engulf the entire globe, regardless of what season you are experiencing. Portals shaped like your silhouette can appear in meditation or randomly if the situation warrants. This portal is unique in many ways as it is incredibly personal and will not draw an alarm to consciousness. Archangel Humberto, renowned warrior, is a caravan expert who ensures safe travels. He can make things feel more magical and mysterious while entering new territory or on an adventure. The energy Archangel Herbert is most known for is excitement. It is almost hard to contain yourself when he is around. We ask Archangel Humberto to escort us to our highest timeline and help us remember to enjoy the joy of the journey. The consciousness of humanity is steadily rising, and the effects of ascension are genuinely manifesting. Many were hoping that this would manifest as an instant pastel skies and diamond castles, but we have decided to take a more peaceful and gradual walk to that destination. The Pleiadians are desperately trying to reach out and are baffled at why their messages are in discord. They are aware something is scrambling their transmission, but this will resolve shortly as Archangel Zulfael starts to investigate what seems like a complicated situation in the macro universe. So far, we know that there is a strange quantum entanglement issue happening with ourselves and the Pleiadians. As we all know, the Pleiadians are ourselves on a future timeline. We may be causing a massive quantum entanglement situation by interacting. The other thing is that Pleiadians, like humans, come in all different sizes, shapes, and colors. The artist depicts the Pleiadians with specific physical attributes, which is most certainly not an exclusive look. I will refrain from diving any further into the reasoning behind the stereotypical look. Most people are just trying to figure it out loud. Never before have we seen such public displays of spiritual journeys. This statement is not to cause alarm, but it is something to be aware of, as so many people wish to express their version of the truth based upon limited understanding. Be careful not to discourage the searcher, but encourage them to dive deeper instead. It is an effective strategy to set a metaphysical modality a few seconds into the future. For example, if it is 11:10, set the violet frame to engulf the earth at 11:11. We must encourage you to test this notion for your win personal research and find your own unique sweet spot with this. Philosophical buffet. Never assume that you know what tomorrow will be like. Things can change in the blink of an eye. Man makes plans and the Creator laughs. Your higher divine can call you to a different path at any moment. Although it does help to put in requests, there is always a higher purpose that can get called in at any time. Label no one, but allow them to label themselves as they wish. The individual has the power to define themselves however they choose. We must always respect their wishes. The impulses of life rule the world. The source of these impulses is the key to how pleasant an experience it will be. How many teachers have come and gone only to leave the earth the same way? We will not succeed working in the physical, but we will achieve success working in the non-physical. We must dare to change the landscape of reality, as this is the only effective way to change the world. The impulses inside humanity are where these battles manifest, and it is far too powerful to contain once it hits physicality. It's best to interpret these impulses before they cause any damage. The purpose of a leader is to take care of their people. A leader is the first in battle and the last to eat. If the understanding that a leader is responsible for an extended family is not present, that leader should step down. Leadership comes in many forms, macro and micro. Nevertheless, a leader does not sit on a throne. It's a job making sure every person in the clan has their basic needs met. Every village has a grumpy smurf. There is a good and evil in all things, people and groups. Even the most fantastic star races have a naysayer or two, and they are genuinely sacred beings for balancing the universe in such a way. Although even the roles of the protagonists will change as reality evolves. The word alien is as nasty of a term as can be. There is no such thing as an alien, as nothing in this universe is strange and unusual to its creator. We would love to see this notion removed from targeting any sentient life form, regardless of its origins. All life are forms and interpretations of energy created by infinitely expanding Creator Source. In regards to developing one's abilities, consistency cannot be understated. Like any other muscle, natural ability can fade away without constant use. It is crop circle season in the southern hemisphere. Many greetings will come via this medium. The tools and the assignments today are in the link in the description below. This is from archangelicalendar.com. Today from Divine Sister of the Light, Lynn Hayes. 2-9-21, the meaning of Saturn, sextile Chiron, the shape of healing. The first of three exact alignments between Saturn in Aquarius and Chiron in Aries takes place today. Chiron is the planet of wounding and healing, and it is instrumental in bridging the human experience between Saturn's focus on the mundane and practical to Uranus, the planet which is symbolized by the pouring of wisdom from the stars to the earth. For this reason, the symbolism of this harmonious sextile between Saturn and Chiron, healing the human personality, can help us to make that leap to the transformation of Saturn squaring Uranus, which forces a radical departure from that which is known and expected. The energies are building for the new moon on the 11th. The moon conjoins Pluto today at the end of Capricorn, forcing the abandonment of something we thought was important before moving into the brand newness of the Aquarius new moon stellium, six planetary bodies in Aquarius. Under the influence of Saturn sextile Chiron, we can more easily heal something broken within us. Right now, all it takes is acknowledging that weakness and the intention to heal, and Saturn and Chiron will do the rest. Today from Divine Sister of the Light, Leah, White Horse, Lua Astrology, Sun conjunct Pallas in Aquarius, Saturn in Aquarius sextile Chiron in Aries. Saturn sextile to Chiron is the first of three this year, and it's the medicine for the difficult Saturn-Uranus square. It's time to take responsibility for chronic problems, face our weaknesses, understand our vulnerabilities. Karmic lessons are interwoven with suffering. Maybe we have struggled to assert ourselves or been too afraid to deal with anger or competitiveness. Maybe we don't know where we fit in and feel like we don't belong. Whatever the cause of pain and wounding, there is much to learn from it. Both Chiron and Saturn are great teachers. The more we work on our individual pain, the more society heals. Self-improvement is the foundation stone for the future of humanity. Recovery is possible. Our inner wise woman steps forward to offer up brilliant breakthroughs through illuminating patterns. Now we see the connection from here to there, the trail of experience from one event to another, that shaped us into the person we are today. Don't be afraid to break the pattern if something needs to change. From LeahWhitehorse.com. Today from the Zolkin Times, Kin 5-7, Red, Overtone Earth. Overtone is the name for the number 5, and its keywords are empower, radiance, and command. The fifth day is like a shift into high gear, and since we are in the wave spell of the Red Skywalker, that means that our adventures are getting very interesting. If you have been getting out of your comfort zone by now, you should be feeling very empowered. Today is Red Earth, which represents evolution, synchronicity, and navigation. If we are facing the right direction, we can evolve as synchronicity increases. If you are heading in the wrong direction, nothing will come together easily, and you will hit brick walls. Consider how you are navigating today and redirect yourself if necessary. This will be a useful process that will help you evolve. Today from Divine Sister of the Light, Christina Papagiorgio, Red Overtone Earth, Kin 57, 9 February 2021, Empowering Evolution, 9-2, 2021, equal 9-2-5, equal 9-7, equal 16, equal 7, 9 Endings, Destiny, Service, Humanity, 2 Twins, Pair, Couple, Cooperation, 5 Liberation, Change, Transformation, Freedom, 7. Magic, Mysticism, Solitude, Initiation, Spiritual. Kin 5-7 equal 12 equal 3, Holy Trinity, Joy, Creativity. Today is another special and significant day as Kin 57, Red Overtone Earth, is one of the 13 clair prophecy signs discovered on the tomb lid of Mayan King Pakal Votan, a magically radiant day. The overtone radiance grounding in Mother Earth, heaven and earth, as above, so below. Day 5 in the Red Skywalker wave spell of awakening, exploration, and new adventures. Today we are navigating through our new adventures, following the synchronicities and natural cycles of our planet to accelerate our evolution. Tone of creation, overtone, tone 5 in the spiritual realm, action commands, power empowers, essence radiance. Number 5 represents the center, core purpose, foundation, and central intent. It is the center of the wheel from which all the spokes emanate. This is the phase where the energy of creation returns to the center and then radiates outwards. Overtones command the unbounded. They order it to be, and so it becomes. Their power radiates from their soul essence through a pure connection to Source. This is the true source of unlimited power. The fifth day of the Red Skywalker wave spell is the one that empowers. When we give ourselves permission to leave the past behind and aim higher, we can grow and expand to transform our lives. Which aspects of your life or outlook would you like to transform in order to feel more empowered? Today's question is, how can I learn from the past in order to empower myself, others, and my world so that we can all radiate as sovereign solar beings? Thus, we have a very beautiful and powerful ancient code activated today, linking the past, present, and future into this now wondrous moment of divine magic. Blessed be, we are free. Go forth and radiate your solar power today. In Lakek Alakin, Christina White, Magnetic World Bridger, Kin 66, Kin 57, Red Overtone Earth. The mantra, the code for today is, I empower in order to evolve. Commanding synchronicity, I seal the matrix of navigation. With the overtone tone of radiance, I am guided by the power of life force. And on this powerful day of empowerment, activation, and transformation, let us know, beloved beings of light, in the comments below, what you are experiencing, your dreams, your visions, your synchronicities. And if you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe and click the subscribe button below and the little bell to get notification on future updates. And as always, we have a link in the description below the video on the transcriptions of today's transmissions, and we archive these on our website, primedisclosure.com. I'd like to also thank everyone for your support and pledges on Patreon and your donations. We rely on our pledges on Patreon and donations for our living expenses and bringing our visions and missions into fruition. So we appreciate each and every one of you. If you'd like to support our work and mission, you can make a pledge on patreon.com/primedisclosure. We are in the process of transmitting our 33-day of I Am Saint Germain discourses over the next 33 days. Today we uploaded our first, so if you're on our Patreon page, be sure to go check that out. And we have many more teachings and trainings to come. One of them, I am contemplating opening an online dojo through Patreon, teaching many martial arts, Shaolin, Mao Shan, Kun Lun, Wudang, Demak, many different arts, physical, spiritual healing arts, and martial arts, Kung Fu. We also do Kung Fu Tea, which I'll be teaching through Patreon in the near future. After 33 days, we'll be bringing many more works to all of you. So thank you all for your support. I'd like to also thank Divine Sister of the Light, Jean Sibley, for your donation today. Thank you, Divine Angel of Light. I'd like to also thank our Divine Angels in Las Vegas, anchoring the codes. G from myvegasdrivers.com, thank you for your pledge and support, our Angels in Las Vegas. Aho, and thank you for help keeping us fed. We appreciate you all. We also have a link in the description if you'd like to make a one-time donation on PayPal. And now, last but not least, I'd like to thank all of you that are supporting my Sacred Condors art business on Etsy. Thank you, Divine Angel of Light, A Pretty Sweet Life, for your beautiful review that you left for my Sacred Condor. If you've purchased one of her goddess totems, please be sure to leave positive feedback and reviews. This helps her to get more traffic on Etsy if you'd like to purchase one of her beautiful handmade one-of-a-kind goddess totems. You can do so at lunagoddessart.com. Go there, take a look at them. You'll receive activation just from the energy, the colors, the light, the love that she has transmitted and put into these handmade goddess totems. So thank you all for supporting her and her great works. We end today's transmission with a divine decree. I am an instrument of God. I am weaving my gifts, talents, skills, knowledge, strength, courage, compassion, and love into the tapestry of the divine plan for the new earth. I am responding to my heart's call. I am God in action. I am consecrating my thoughts, words, feelings, and actions to be the greatest force of good I can be on this planet. I am making a positive difference every day. Through the focus of my attention, I am expressing the following divine truths. I am one with all life. I am divine love. I am infinite abundance. I am the harmony of my true being. I am vibrantly healthy and eternally youthful. I am a peace commanding presence. The actions I take every day improve my family, my job, my community, my city, my country, and the world. I have a healing touch. I am communing with the angelic kingdom and the elemental kingdom. I am transfiguring this planet into the new earth, and so it is. So join together, beloved bro stars and sisters of light, in the I am presence of the eternal light, the eternal life of infinitely expanding Creator Source. Transmit these divine decrees into the world, into consciousness, into this field of energy to uplift, to ascend, and to transform into the new Eden, heaven on earth. Have a beautiful and blessed day. The eagle and the condor love you all. Namaste.